Hello students, my name is Yogesh Jain and our today's topic is active and passive voice. Active and passive voice. This is the chapter. And what is active voice and passive voice? We have sentences like, look at this sentence, Ram plays football. And I can also write this sentence like, football is played by Ram. What is the meaning of the sentence? Of this sentence, meaning is same, but in first sentence grammatical structure is different and in second sentence structure is different. In first sentence, what we are saying, Ram plays football. Who is playing football? Ram is playing football. So who is the doer of the action? Ram. And what is Ram? Ram is subject, right? Plays is verb and football is object. So in first sentence, who is the doer of action? The subject is the doer of the action. So it is called active voice. The sentence is in active voice because subject is the doer of action, not object. Object is not the doer of action. Okay, now look the second sentence. Football is played by Ram. Now, in this sentence, who is the doer of action? Football. Football is the doer of action. No, football is not doer of the action. The doer of action is object, and here object is Ram, right? So in second sentence, subject football is not active, it is passive. And in first sentence, subject is active, right? In this sentence, in first sentence, subject is active. And in second sentence, subject is passive. Got it? So, second sentence will be called that it is in passive voice. Correct? So, when in the sentence subject is the doer of action, then we will say that verb is active, subject is active. So, the sentence will be in active voice. But in passive voice, subject is not the doer of action, object is doer of action. So, subject is passive, so verb will be called in passive form. So, the sentence will be called passive voice. Correct? These are active voice and passive voice. Meaning are same. राम फुटबॉल खेलता है. इन सेकेंड सेंटेंस फुटबॉल राम के द्वारा खेली जाती है. सेंस इज सेम दैट राम इज प्लेइंग फुटबॉल. राम प्लेज फुटबॉल. बट स्ट्रक्चर्स आर डिफरेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू एक्टिव वॉइस एंड पैसिव वॉइस. गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एक्टिव वॉइस. इट मीन्स वॉट वी आर डूइंग, वॉट वी कम टू नो दैट in active voice, what happens? Subject is the doer of action.
okay, and in passive voice subject is not the doer of the action, it is receiver of the action. Subject is the receiver of the action. Got it?
Very simple. So we have a question, why we use two structures for the same sentence? Ram plays football and we are saying football is played by Ram. What is the need of this second structure of passive voice? So why we use passive voice? When subject is not important for us, we only want to talk about the verb and object, okay, where object is more important for us than subject, then we can write sentence in passive voice. Okay, like we have a sentence, washerman is washing my clothes. Washerman is washing my clothes. What is this? This is active voice because subject is the doer of action. Correct. Now, who is important for us? Washerman or clothes? Tell me, who is important for us? I think clothes are important to us. Washerman is only a source who washes our clothes. So we can also say, yeah, if object clothes are important for us, then we will focus on object, okay, not subject. So we use passive voice. So we say, my clothes are being washed. What we say? My clothes are being washed, and this sentence is in passive voice because object is important for us, clothes. Who is the doer of action? Doer is not important for us. So for this purpose, for focusing on object and verb, we write sentences in passive voice. Okay, that is the use of active voice, that is the use of passive voice. Okay, so what we are to do? We will be given a sentence in active voice. Mostly we are given sentences in active voice, and we are to convert those sentences into passive voice. Hame active voice mein sentence milega, hame usko passive voice mein convert karna hai. This is our project. So we have subject, we have verb, we have object, okay, and we are to do something with these three elements. So there are some rules to convert a sentence from active voice into passive voice. First of all, let us look at those simple rules. To change active voice into passive voice, what we are to do? We are going to discuss about some rules to change active voice into passive voice. Look, number one, what happens? We have subject in active voice and object in active voice. To convert a subject, to convert an active voice into passive voice, first what thing we do? That we convert subject into object and object into subject. Means subject of active voice becomes the object of passive voice, and object of active voice becomes subject of passive voice. We interchange subject and object, means subject becomes object, okay, and object becomes subject. Clear? Okay. Number two, what we do? always use third form of verb in passive voice. We always use third form of verb in passive voice, whether it is present tense, past tense or future tense. We always use third form of verb in passive voice, and we use helping verb before main verb, that is V3 in passive voice. We always use helping verb before main verb, V3 in passive voice. What does it mean? We know that we use helping verb before main verb. What is this? So it means that in simple present tense also, in simple past tense also, in affirmative sentence, we use helping verb before main verb. We know that in simple present tense, affirmative sentences, we don't use helping verb. In simple past tense, affirmative sentence, we don't use helping verb. But in passive voice, we use helping verb in those tenses also. Okay? Chalo. Now, number 4. Only sentences having object are only sentences having object are changed into passive voice. Only those sentences who consists of an object converted into passive voice. What does it mean? It means we have sentence Ram plays cricket. Ram plays cricket. Ram is subject, plays verb, cricket object. So we can convert this sentence into passive voice like cricket is played by Ram. Okay, but if we have a sentence that doesn't have object like Ram is playing, Ram is playing, then how can we convert this sentence into passive voice? Because this sentence doesn't have an object. So sentences which has object can be converted into passive voice. Got it? Okay. Number 5, we use by before the object of passive voice. It means in passive voice we use by before object, like by Ram, by him, by me, chair is broken by you, homework has been done by me, okay, cricket has been played by Rohan. So by Rohan, by me, by you, what are these? These are objects of passive voice and we use by before those objects. Clear? Okay. Now let's have some examples. Let me write some examples of passive voice. Like I have a sentence, Rohan has broken the chair. Rohan has broken the chair. We have this sentence in active voice because subject is the doer of action,
who performed the action? Subject. Subject is active, so verb is active and the sentence is in active voice.
Now we will convert this sentence into passive voice. This is subject, this is verb, and this is object. Clear? So first rule, we will convert subject into object and object into subject. So we will take object as subject of passive voice. We are going to convert the sentence into passive voice. So first of all, the chair is object of this sentence and it will be converted into subject of passive voice. So first take the total object here at the place of subject, and that is the chair. Now it has become the subject. Okay, object has been converted into subject. Okay, now we have verb has been. Okay, so according to rule, we will take or we will convert this has broken into has been broken. Okay, this is now verb, total verb. We are using V3 in passive voice. Whatever the tense we have in active voice, we will take third form of verb in passive voice. Okay, now this is Rohan, this is subject, and subject will become object of the passive voice. So we'll take Rohan here. Okay, but we will take by before object. This is rule that we add by before object, so it will be written like by Rohan. Got it? Very simple. The chair has been broken by Rohan. Now why has been converted into has broken, has been converted into has been broken. So we will read it tense by tense, that what helping verb we use before the main verb. Okay, so first of all we will read about pronoun, that we convert subject into object, we convert object into subject. So how pronoun are converted from subject to object, let us discuss about it. So like we have I am doing my work, I am doing my work. What will the passive form? The work is being done by I. No, we will not write like it. The work is being done by I. I will be converted into objective form, and the objective form of I is me. Okay, so let me write the subjective form of each pronoun. And objective form of each pronoun. Like we have first person I. I is subjective form and its objective form is me. Okay. Now we talk about we. We is subjective form. We are going, we are playing, we are brothers. We is subject in all these sentences. But the objective form of we is us. It's us. They are coming to meet us. My father has scolded us. Okay, the teacher has given some homework to us. So all in all these sentences, us is object and objective form is us of we. Now we talk about you. Subjective form and objective form of you is same. You will remain you. Okay, now he will be converted into him.
she becomes her. Now we talk about it. It becomes it. It will remain same, okay? And now they. They becomes them. Okay. So these are subjective form and these are objective form. Okay. In passive voice, we can see all these pronoun like by me, by us, by you, by him, by her, by it, by them. Okay. So these are changes of subjective and objective form. If we talk about noun, noun remains same in subjective form and objective form. Like I said, Monica has done her work. Monica is subject and work has been done by Monica. Monica is object here. So noun remains same. Okay. Okay, so we have learned about the definition, about the concept of active voice and passive voice. We have learned about some rules of converting an active voice into passive voice and what are subjective form and objective form of pronouns. We have read about it. Thank you.